principal's office, Sunday Lane Grade School. Mr. Crane speaking. Mrs. Martin. No, that's all right. You're not too late. Yes, if you could get here in 5 minutes, that would be quite okay. Yes. Thank you for calling, Mrs. Martin, and I'm looking forward to meeting Barbara Martin's mother. Goodbye. Could you send Mrs. Bond in, please? Thank you.
Mr. Crane?
Sure, Mrs. Bond.
Yes.
Would you have a seat, please?
Thank you. Although I am ashamed to admit it.
Oh, no, no, there's no reason that you should feel that way.
I've never been called to the principal's office.
Well, these things will happen, Mrs. Bond. They will happen.
Not with my Carol, imagine. Fighting with another girl. Simply horrible.
Well, I'm glad you feel that way about it, Mrs. Bond. Some mothers would condone their children's bad behavior.
Not me. I think it's terrible.
That's why I sent that note to you. I like to keep the parents informed, let them know what's going on.
Yes, and I agree. I think that's very important.
Mrs. Martin, the mother of the other little girl involved, receives a similar note.
And has she been to see you?
She'll be here momentarily.
Oh, you mean after I leave?
No, I mean while you're here. I want you to get to meet her and talk with her.
I couldn't meet her face to face. I'm just too embarrassed.
I'm sure you'll be fine. I've got plenty of these cases, and they all work out fine.
Well, if you think that's best.
I do, and thank you. Hello? Principal's office. Yes, if you send her in, right? Thank you. It's Mrs. Martin. She's here now.
Mr. Crane?
Mrs. Martin.
Thank you. I'm so sorry for being late.
Oh, that's all right. I'm just having a nice chat here with Mrs. Bond.
Oh, Mrs. Bond. Oh, how do you do? You must be the mother of?
Carol. I'm ashamed to admit it.
Oh, no more so than I. This is like one of the most mortifying experiences in my entire life.
I know how you feel.
Well, won't you sit down, Mrs.
Yes, thank you.
Now, I suppose you're wondering why I invited you to my office like this.
Well, yes. I mean, it is rather unusual. I've never been to a principal's office before. Except once when I was little, of course.
I found it's the best solution in these cases. Your little girls have misbehaved, and I'm sure that you want to find them. Real reason behind it, though. Reason behind the reason, so to speak. So that you can prevent it from happening again.
Well, naturally. Well, of course.
And you've received my notes telling you what happened. And I thought that you'd like to talk to each other and get the other side of things, wouldn't you?
Naturally. Of course we would.
Well, then, between you, you can decide what punishment, if any, should be imposed on Carol and Barbara. I'll give you 5 minutes to talk things over. By that time, you should have arrived at a settlement. 5 minutes, ladies.
Well, I hardly know what to say. Neither. You know, perhaps it may have been entirely my Barbara's fault.
Well, it could have been my Carol's fault.
Though, you know, it's the first time she's ever been involved in anything like this.
Well, my Carol's too. This is her first experience.
You know, at home, she's a perfect little lady.
Well, and my Carol was very particular about her manners.
Oh, I'm sure you are, Mrs. Bond. One can tell just by looking at her that she's had a beautiful, lovely home.
Thank you, Mrs. Martin. And I'm sure you've provided a lovely home for your family as well.
Well then, how do you think we should resolve this? Dear.
Well, darling, I think if your Barbara just apologizes to my Carol, that we can forget it ever happened and just simply move on.
Well, I think that's an exceptionally good idea. except for one thing, dear.
Oh, what's that, darling?
I'm sure it's just a slip of your tongue, but you meant your Carol would apologize to my Barbara, didn't you?
Oh, no. After all, it was your Barbara, darling, that started it.
You know, it just pains me to contradict you, my dear, but it was your Carol that started it.
I believe it was your Barbara.
Your Carol?
It was your Barbara.
Your Carol?
Intimating that I would lie about such a thing.
You know, I believe my daughter implicitly. She was walking along the court, minding her own business, when your daughter, Carol, my dear, came up to her and kicked her like that.
I think you're terribly confused. I believe it was your Barbara that came up and just pushed on Carol like that.
She kicked her. Your Carol kept on kicking my Barbara. She had her hair out.
A drop of a precious